You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
It's the middle of the year. Are you still on the road to destiny, or have you veered off course? It's time to reset your dream, and I'll be right back to tell you how. See you in a second.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success from the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power. The program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Yes, it is the middle of the year already. I cannot believe it that we're about to end the first half of the year and begin the second half of 2014 already. And my question to you is, are you still on the road to destiny, to the dreams, to the goals that you set for yourself at the middle of the year? Or have you veered off course? You see, anything that is in constant motion has a tendency, if it's not realigned, to begin to veer off course. And we are no different. As humans, we are constantly in motion. And so there comes a critical time for us to go and realign. Realign our energy, realign our goals, realign our dreams in the direction of our destiny. And the best time, the critical time to do it is the middle of the year. You see, the statistics prove that most people by the middle of the year, by the first half of the year, they have totally lost sight of the goals and dreams that they set for themselves. And then, of course, you know what that means. It means that by the end of the year, another year bites the dust. They are no closer to their dreams than they were at the beginning of the year. And then they go through the same vicious circle in the new year. You know, they are all motivated and they have these goals and dreams. And then, you know, they veer, of course. And then, you know, they never attain their destiny, and then they go through this same vicious circle over and over and over again. But my mission is to ensure that you get to your destination, that you achieve your goals and dreams. And that is why I have set this program at this critical time of the year for you to reset your dream. And what do I mean by reset? What do I mean by reset? It just really means realigning. It just really means that you take time out to evaluate, to measure, and then realign, you know, your goals and your dreams in the direction that you really will have them going. And so this broadcast is really all about how to reset, power to reset, power to reset your dream. And you want to get notes. You want to take notes. I beg your pardon. You want to get your notepad, your iPad, whatever, because I'm telling you, I'm going to be sharing some very powerful strategies to help you to reset your dream and guarantee that you finish 2014 strong. And so let's talk about those those tools and those strategies, the power to reset. And the first thing you want to do, that you know, in this process of resetting your dream, is first and foremost is to take time out. Take time out of your busy schedule. I find that, you know, this summer period, the middle of the year, is a time where people get really very distracted. You know, it's a time where people really get very distracted with all the hustle and the bustle. You know, the sun is out and you know, we just want to have fun and all of that. And there's nothing wrong with that. But it just means that if you're not careful, you know, and you're not intentional about resetting, about keeping your goals before you, you lose so much momentum during that summer period that it's so hard to recalibrate again in the fall and then, you know, come across the finish line strong. So that is why, you know, in the midst of all the hustle and the bustle and the cookouts and vacations, which I believe in and which are much needed, the first step to resetting, though, is for you to make time. Just make time. Make time. And that time could be an hour, it could be a couple of hours, you know, to do the following. So make time out of your busy schedule, put it down, schedule it. You know that if you don't schedule it, it's not going to happen. So make the time. Make the time. The power to reset is what we're talking about. Power to reset your dream is what we are talking about today on Inspired Success. And I want to share with you the strategies, because you know my mission, you know, is to help you as America's dream midwife, is to ensure that you reach your dream, you reach your destiny. So make the time, schedule it, put it down 1 hour at the very least, you know, and find a place of quietness, you know, place of solitude. So that's the first step, 1 hour in solitude at least. And then measure where you are. Measure where you are. Where am I? How far away am I from my dreams? What have I accomplished, you know? So if at the beginning of the year, for example, you set, like we all do, if you set a goal to lose 30 pounds, where are you? Measure that. How many pounds have you lost? What is left to accomplish? You know, for example, maybe a financial goal. This year you want to earn six figures, for example. Where are you? How much have you been able to gross, you know? Where are you? So you need to really take the time, find a place of quiet, and measure where you are. Measure where you are. Because if you don't measure, you don't know what is left. You don't know what is left. And so measure. Measure is the first step, power step, to resetting your dream. And then the next thing is to affirm and acknowledge. Oh, I can't emphasize this enough. Your successes. You know, I was thinking about myself, you know, and I was thinking about this, because this is very applicable to me. You know, affirm, acknowledge, and appreciate, and be thankful for where you are, for what you have accomplished so far. And honestly, like I was saying, this is very applicable to me, because, you know, I'm this kind of person that, because I'm such a high achiever and I set such high goals for myself and all of that, that when I fall short of my goals, I don't take time enough to affirm, acknowledge, and appreciate what I accomplished. I bemoan what is left, you know? And you know what that does to us? It puts us in a negative energy, in a negative space, you know, where we're depressed rather than a joyful state, you know, where we're happy, you know? And we know that when we're depressed and discouraged, you know, it kills our motivation, you know, it kills our drive, and it hinders us from really pressing forward, you know? So it's so important, very extremely important, and I am learning this, and I'm preaching to myself here, and I'm finally practicing it, you know, where, you know, you really, really take time out and just be grateful. Affirm those accomplishments. Give yourself a pat on the back. You know, I was saying that to a colleague of mine as well, you know, who called me recently and was like, oh, Bola, you know, blah, blah, blah. You know, it's coming slow, the big breakthrough and all of that. But I have seen so much that she had accomplished already in the year. And I said to her, you know, hey, girlfriend, pat yourself on the back. You're doing great. Affirm your successes, you know. You've done tremendous work, and you've done so well. She worked on her website. She's out there in the community. She's on different TV shows, and she's speaking and all of that. And I'm like, come on, celebrate that. Affirm that. Acknowledge that and give God thanks. Be grateful. And honestly, I can't really overemphasize this power step, because it will really liberate you, will really just literally open you up, you know, and encourage you to keep going. It will open you up to receive more, and it will just encourage you. It will free you. You know, you'll be light, you'll be happy, and it will motivate you to go even further. So that is a very critical step in resetting your dream. So if you're just tuning in to Inspire Success, we're talking about the power to reset your dream. It's the middle of the year, right? And it's this critical period where if we don't be intentionally reset, you know, recalibrate, it's so easy to veer off course. It's so easy to lose momentum. And you know what that means? It means that the end of another year comes. You know, we are no closer than we were at the beginning, and we go through the same vicious cycle, and then we set another goal, and we're all excited at the beginning of the new year. And then, you know, it's just the same old, same old. And I want it to be different for you. You know that America's Dream Midwife really is passionate about you reaching your God-given destiny and your God-given dreams. So today's broadcast is about the power to reset. And so the first step, you know, in doing it, like I said, is to make time, create the time, you know, out of your busy summer schedule. Schedule it, put it on the calendar, okay? At least an hour. Find a quiet place and then measure where you are. Measure where you are. The next step is to affirm, acknowledge, and appreciate God for your accomplishments and for your successes. Honestly, you have to appreciate God. And I was reading a quote somewhere, you know, and it said that if you have no reason to be grateful, it says, feel your pulse. your pulse. Okay. And I thought that was really very neat. I put it on my Facebook page as my Thankful Tuesday. Feel your pulse. At the very least, thank God that you're still alive. You made it through the first half of the year. You survived, you know. And so praise God. Thank God. Take time to be grateful, to give thanks. So that is an A, actually. So M is measured. This is obviously after you've taken time, you've found a place of quiet, and then measure, and then, you know, affirm, appreciate, value, and then celebrate, reward yourself. You know, reward yourself. You know, go out somewhere, treat yourself to something you've always wanted. You know, just reward yourself. You know, nobody's gonna do it for you if your employer doesn't appreciate you. You know, your spouse or whoever. You know, you value yourself. You reward yourself, and like I said, give yourself a pat on the back and say, Bola, you've done a fantastic job. It's amazing what you've done. And go out and celebrate. And I'm celebrating this year. I'm going on vacation. I'm taking my boys on vacation to Europe. So that's very exciting. It's a way of rewarding myself, you know, and saying, hey, you know what? God is good. And I've come a long way. I may not be where I'd like to be yet, you know, but I've come a long way. I've come a long way. I've worked hard. I've paid the price. I've sacrificed. hey, you know, let's celebrate, you know? So that's the next thing. Reward yourself. Celebrate. And do it in a way that fuels your passion. So whether that, it could be even little things, you know, it doesn't have to be like a vacation to Europe, like me, if you can't afford it, you know, but it can be little things. It can be just taking a weekend out on a retreat. It can be reading a book, going to the movies, taking a walk on the beach, whatever, you know, but reward yourself. So we've got three power steps, or maybe if we can call it four. Making the time, the solitude, which is the S, the M is to measure, really be, you know, specifically measure where you are, you know, what you've accomplished and what is left. Measure, evaluate, you know, so that you have a sense of what is left. And then I said affirm, acknowledge, the A, appreciate, be thankful, be grateful, give thanks. Give thanks. Amen. And then I said, reward yourself, you know, celebrate your victories, celebrate your successes. And then you strategize or you plan, you know, whichever a word you want to use. They're both kind of the same to me. So you now begin to strategize. You come up with a concrete plan now, with measurable steps, because now you've measured where you are, you know where you're going, you see where you've veered off course, you know, hopefully, you see what is left, you are able to measure and assess the things that worked, the things that didn't work, so you kind of eliminate the distractions and come up with a concrete plan with measurable steps for the second half of the year. You have to plan. You know what they say? I think it's Stephen Covey who said it, that if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. If you fail to plan, you plan to fail. You know, so you got to have a plan. And so Inspired Success is the show. Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, is your host. And today is about the power to reset your dream. This mid-year time and season is a critical time for you to realign and for you not to lose momentum so that you can finish strong. You can come across that line and say, yes, I made it. I reached destiny. I reached my goals. I reached exactly the place that God wanted me to reach in this year. You know, and so we've looked at the power steps, how to do it. And you know the exciting thing? You know I always do this for you. I never just leave you in limbo. I always come alongside you. I've created two programs this summer. You know, one of them is a teleconference, and I'll be telling you all about it from July 1 to 10th. You know, it's a prayer teleconference that is geared towards prayerfully resetting. And one of them is a live workshop on Thursday, July 24th at 6 p.m. right here in West Hartford for you to come. And then we are going to actually work together on a strategic plan. Oh, wow. How exciting is that? So, you know, so we've looked at the steps. So save those dates, by the way, July 1 to 10th, Reset Your Dream, Power to Reset Your Dream, Prayer and Fasting Teleconference. And then July 24th, a live event, a live conference, a live workshop, Power to Reset Your Dream, at an evening of inspired success. And my question is, your networking, you know? So we're looking at the strategies, we're measuring, and we're going to come together with a strategic plan. So if you're in the area, you know, hey, make sure that you're a part of that. RoyalProclamations.com is where you go to register. RoyalProclamations.com is where you go to register and learn more. You know, so if you're in the area, obviously you do it in a community of people. You have me to keep you accountable. It's so much more effective. But if you don't, if you're not in the area, you know, then you have the the tips and the tools right here on this show for you to do it by yourself. And then, of course, you can always call in regardless of where you are in the world to the teleconference at 9:30 p.m. each night, Eastern Standard Time, July 1 to 10th. Amen. So we've looked so far at four of the five power steps, I believe. We've looked at solitude, making time for some, for space, for solitude. We've looked at you measuring really where you are against where you're going. We've looked at you affirming, acknowledging, and appreciating and being thankful for where you are already. We've looked at you rewarding yourself, celebrating your victories, you know, just celebrating that. And then we've also, we look at five of the six. We've now looked at the sixth one, which is, the fifth one, which is you plan, you strategize, you re-strategize, you come up with a new plan with measurable steps. You know, you eliminate the distractions, you eliminate things that are not working, you eliminate the negativity, and then re-strategize and retarget and refocus and in a way you can constantly measure that. If you fail to plan, you plan to face. And lastly, but not the least, is you pray. So these are the six parts. Yes, prayer. Come on. You know, there's a scripture that I live by. It says that commit your plans. It's Proverbs 16, verse 9. Proverbs 16, and Proverbs, you know, is the book of wisdom. Oh, yes. You should read the book of Proverbs. A lot of wisdom there for successful living, just for living life generally successfully and all of that. A lot of tips and tools there. But Proverbs 16, 9 says that you should commit your plans to the Lord and He will establish your steps. You know, and then Proverbs, I told you, Proverbs is just full of wisdom. Chapter 3, verse 5 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. In all your ways, acknowledge Him. Acknowledge Him, and He'll bring your desires to pass. You know, so after you plan, you strategize, you know, when you're now committed to God in prayer, prayerful preparation prevents poor performance. That's a quote of one of my colleagues. He was a pastor. I heard it from him first. Prayerful preparation prevents poor performance. It's prayer is just acknowledging that, you know what, God, I need your mercy. I need your favor. You know, Ecclesiastes says that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. So it's not really about how well you know how to strategize. You know, the grace of God upon you, you know, the favor of God, you know, to do what you cannot do, to open certain doors, to give you goodwill, and so on and so forth. So pray, 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 and pray. You know this woman is a woman of prayer. And that is why I created the Prayer and Fasting Teleconference, July 1 to 10, 10 days, 10 days of the month of the second, the first 10 days of the second half of the year. Let us come together in fasting. So that means you sacrifice a meal or two or three, whatever you want to give up for those 10 days, and just commit, you know, the second half of the year to God's and thanking Him, being grateful for how far He has brought you into the new year, into the year, just being grateful. And then also then saying, you know what, God, I give you this second half. Let your mercy continue. Let your favor continue. Let your love continue. Let your protection continue over me and my family. It is so critical. You know, we don't, prayer is not something, and I say this all the time, that we use as a reactionary defense, you know, in reactionary, or as a defensive weapon, you know, when we're in crisis. No, we can use it as an offensive weapon to actually push back the powers of darkness, you know. And so I want to invite you, July 1 to 10, join me. The call letters for the teleconference prayer line is on the screen. And It's 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for every day of those 10 days. And we're going to be praying together. And then, of course, then July 24th, Thursday, July 24th, at the AHN Hamilton Heights in West Hartford, Connecticut, is our evening of inspired success to measure where our net worth and our network and, you know, our annual media networking extravaganza is just going to be powerful. I'm going to be speaking. There's going to be a seminar workshop where we're going to actually together as a community of like-minded professional people, you know, dreamers and go-getters, we are going to map out a strategy. And I'd love to see you there Thursday, July 24th at 6 p.m. and at AHN Hamilton Heights. All of that info is on the screen and it's available on my website, royalproclamations.com. Of course, you know, Princess Bola is on Facebook as well. I'm on Twitter, I'm on LinkedIn, you know, all the major networking sites. I'm there. And I really would look forward to seeing you at these programs and, you know, really come alongside with you as usual and actually do it together. Do it together. We'll do it together. Do it with you. We'll do the prayer together. We'll pray together. We'll map out the strategy for the second half of the year together. We'll reset together. And I know it's just going to be also very exciting. I'd love to see you. And, you know, I'm so thankful to you for watching Inspired Success and making it actually one of the top 10 viewed shows on our community television. So I want to say thank you to you for that, for tuning in, and obviously leave your comments and post and all of that. I'd love to hear from you. You know that. I love to hear from you. So, hey, on Facebook, Royal Proclamations, Princess Bola - Royal Proclamations, leave me a note on the Inspired Success TV page of Facebook. Leave me a note on my website. Leave me a note. And better still, come on down and plug in. So I'm not out of words, as you know, but we're out of time. It's the power for you to go and now reset your dream. You got it. Now go do it. Go do it. Go create the time of solitude. Go measure where you are against where you're going. Go affirm, acknowledge, appreciate your accomplishments. Go celebrate and reward yourself, and then plan and then pray. I love you. I look forward to seeing you next month. Have a splendid summer. I'll see you online on the prayer call. I'll see you on July 24th. This is Princess Bola Adelani reminding you, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Put a smile on your face. Life is too short. Keep learning. Keep networking. Keep believing. And keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you soon. God bless. Bye.